Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to discuss diabetic ketoacidosis, which is an acute emergency in diabetic patients. In this lecture, we'll discuss about the etiology of diabetic ketoacidosis, what is the pathogenesis which leads to the development of the ketoacidosis in this condition, how we can diagnose DK or diabetic ketoacidosis, and how we can differentiate between diabetic ketoacidotic coma and hyperosmolar non-ketotic coma. These are the two conditions which can occur, and we have to differentiate between these two by different parameters. Diabetic ketoacidosis is defined as an acute major life-threatening complication of severe uncontrolled diabetes associated with ketoacidosis that requires emergency treatment with insulin and intravenous fluids. It occurs mainly in type 1 diabetic patients, but it is not uncommon in some of the patients with the type 2 diabetes mellitus. It's a state of absolute or relative insulin deficiency, which is aggravated by hyperglycemia, dehydration, and acidosis producing derangements in metabolism. The mortality rate is about 5% if it is not properly handled or treated timely. There are different underlying causes for this one. The most common cause is the concomitant infection, which may be in the form of any chest infection, that may be in the form of some UTI, that may be in the form of the carbuncle or any other disorder which is having infective organisms and causes the fever and stress and burden on the patient. Missed or disrupted insulin treatments is common in 25% of the patients of the diabetic ketoacidosis. It means that somebody with the type 1 diabetes has missed their doses or has changed the dosage regime as per his own will or as per the advice, which has caused the increase in the glucose level, which is very high. Sometimes the newly diagnosed cases, which may be presenting with the diabetic ketoacidosis because they have not been taking any medication, and they may present with this one. And this accounts for about 15% of the cases. In such patients, the Klebsiella pneumoniae is the most common organism, bacterial infection, which is present and leading cause of the bacterial infection in DK. Then there may be causes in the medical or the surgical or emotional stress, the patient going for the surgery or anything else who is on insulin, and stress can aggravate the blood glucose level. There may be mechanical failure of the insulin infusion pump. If the patient is on a regular infusion pump user, then it may cause some problem in there. Now, if we see insulin deficiency or ineffectiveness, that leads to the concomitant increased level of glucagon or cortisol, which are counter-regulatory hormones, growth hormone, epinephrine. This type of the hormonal imbalance enhances hepatic gluconeogenesis, glycogenolysis, and lipolysis, which ultimately leads to development of the or production of the ketone bodies, leading to the osmotic diuresis, hypovolemia, and decreased GFR. which further aggravates the conditions and leads to an acute emergency state. Hepatic gluconeogenesis, glycogenolysis secondary to insulin deficiency, and counterregulatory hormone excess result in severe hyperglycemia while lipolysis increases free serum fatty acids. This metabolism of free fatty acid serves as an alternative energy source and results in the accumulation of acidic intermediate and end metabolite like ketones and keto acids like acetone, acetoacetate, and beta hydroxybutyrate. These are detected in the urine or in the blood. Clinically, patient may present with anorexia, nausea, vomiting, along with polydipsia, polyuria, for last about 24 hours, followed by stupor or coma, or he may be brought to the emergency with in a semi-unconscious state. There will be fruity odor in the breathing, which is due to the acetone. There will be signs of the dehydration, increased heart rate, postural blood pressure fluctuation. Then fever suggests the infection, while WBC count alone is not sufficient because DK per se can cause fever also. This is the clinical presentation, and one must keep in mind that any of the symptoms may not be more pronounced, but biochemical evaluation of the diabetic ketoacidosis is essential. Initial step in the diagnostic approach is testing for the glucose and the ketones. This is the most common thing and most important thing to do. If there is 3 plus glucose in the urine and 3 plus or 4 plus or 2 plus ketones in the urine, then it should immediately click in the mind that it may be a case of diabetic ketoacidosis. The diagnostic criteria for DKA is hyperglycemia, which may be having glucose level more than 250 milligram per deciliter, ketonemia or ketoneuria, then pH less than 7.3 and bicarbonate less than 15 milliequivalent per liter. These three things are very important in the evaluation, biochemical evaluation of diabetic ketoacidosis. Respiratory compensation for this acidotic condition results in rapid shallow breathing. Sporting features for this condition are volume depletion and rapid and shallow breathing. Now, there are two types of the comas which have to be differentiated from diabetic ketoacidosis. One is alcoholic ketoacidosis, and second one we will discuss in the next slide. By definition, alcoholic ketoacidosis occurs in chronic alcoholism, especially after a binge drinking. A person who is drunk a lot, and it always occurs with starvation. This may be common in foreign countries where the alcohol consumption is high. The patient may present with severe abdominal pain and tenderness, and pancreatitis occurs in 75% of the cases. 90% present with glucose level of less than 150 milligram per deciliter. This is the one of the differentiating features from the diabetic ketosis in ketoacidosis coma, in which the glucose level is more. It is rapidly reversed by IV glucose, but remember, give thiamine to avoid beriberi. These are the differences between the diabetic and alcoholic ketoacidosis. Then hyperosmolar non-ketotic coma, in which glucose is more than 600 in DKA is usually not so high as it is hyperosmolar non-ketotic coma. Arterial pH is less than 7.3. It is more than 7.3 in that. Bicarbonate level is less than 15 milliequivalent in DKA. In hyperosmolar non-ketotic coma, it is more than 20. Blood urea nitrogen is less than 25. And in that, it is about more than 30. So, few things are important in this. Like blood glucose level, number two is osmolality. There is a difference between these two. It is less than 320 and it is more than 320. In this, ketones are present in blood and urine both. And in this, they're hyperosmolar, there may be present very small amount, or mostly they are negative in that. A patient presented in dental clinic with periodontal swelling. She gave history of polyuria, polydipsia, and weight loss. From these things, you can diagnose the case that it may be diabetes mellitus. Now, what next can be asked from you? What are the major microvascular complications of this condition? This we have discussed in the previous microvascular complications. So you have to remember macrovascular and microvascular complications in attempting any question related to the exam. A 24-year-old female was brought to the casualty department in semi-comatose condition. Her biochemical profile investigations revealed sodium is 129, which is less. Potassium is 6.1, which is more. Bicarbonate is less. Chloride is 92, which is also less. Glucose is 35 millimole. Normal is up to 11. It means it is quite high. These units are not used. These are the international units, but commonly we use in milligram. pH is 7.28 and urine was positive for the ketones. Patient is suspected to have what? Naturally, it is these features. This one, pH, high, very high glucose level and bicarbonate level. These suggest diabetic ketoacidosis. You may be asked in two ways. Either it can be in the SEQ form or it may be in the MCQ form. In this case, the answer would be diabetic ketoacidosis. A hyperventilating patient is suffering from untreated diabetes. Over the past several days, he has experienced thirst, frequent urination, weight loss, and fatigue. Blood analysis reveals below normal pH, bicarbonate level, and partial pressure of the carbon dioxide and above normal glucose level. Now you have to give the pathophysiology. What is the primary cause of the below normal pH in this patient, which is the case of diabetic ketoacidosis? Or it may be in this one, it is due to ketoacidosis. I'm just discussing these scenarios just with you to familiarize you what type of the questions may be asked. The complication of the diabetic ketoacidosis carries a separate weightage in diabetes because it can be asked in any form, and you will definitely see the cases when you are in the final year or in the house job. Which one of the following plasma glucose level is diagnostic of diabetes mellitus? Select only one answer. This we have discussed in the first lecture or in the second lecture. Fasting plasma glucose more than 100 milligram, fasting plasma glucose more than 140 milligram, fasting plasma more than 126, more than 170, more than 150. Now, here, most students make mistake. They commonly answer this one, more than 100 in the Viva or in the SEQ or in the MCQ. Question is, which one of the plasma glucose level on two occasions is diagnostic of diabetes mellitus? In this case, it is C. So this is 126. I emphasize on this that you must remember this figure. 126 is very important figure to be kept in mind. If it is more than 126 blood glucose level, then he is a case of diabetes mellitus. Now, another scenario, carefully examine the given specimen photograph and read clinical scenario and answer the following. Here you see what's going on, blackening. Immediately, what should come in the mind? It's a complication of what? It may be, it's a 40 years old male, diabetic, developed blackening of the toes. Lab findings were fasting blood glucose 240 milligram, urine glucose 2 positive. Clear cut case of it is a gangrene. What is your diagnosis? Which test is missing in this best, which that is the best indicator of the raised blood glucose level over the last few weeks? This you must answer, and we discussed in the last lecture, it is HbA1c. Now here again you may be asked, it may carry 1 mark, it may carry 2 mark, or it may carry 2 mark. In this way, this SEQ is complete. What are the complications of here? You have to categorize the microvascular and the macrovascular complications. So, diabetic ketoacidosis, you have to differentiate it from the hyperosmolar non-ketotic coma and alcoholic ketoacidosis. And moreover, you have to remember what are the 3 or 4 parameters which are important for the diagnosis of diabetic ketoacidosis. Thank you very much. We'll discuss after finishing this lecture the MCQ in detail in the next lecture. Thank you very much.